In this session, we will determine the length of weld for static loading as well as for dynamic loading. Now let us have problem. Two steel plates 100 mm wide and 12.5 mm thick. 100 mm wide and 12.5 mm thick are to be connected together by double transverse fillet weld. Determine the length of weld for static and dynamic loading. Take stress concentration factor equal to 1.5 and permissible tensile stress equal to 70 Newton per mm square. First of all, we write down the given data. S is equal to 12.5 mm. Sigma T is equal to 70 Newton per mm square. Width equal to 100 millimeter. Kf is equal to 1.5 millimeter. Now this is the figure for the problem. Now first of all, we will determine the length of weld for static loading. Now strength of double transfer fillet weld for static loading is this is the equation. W is equal to 1.414 into S into L into sigma T. Now putting the values of S and sigma T, we will have this equation number 1. Now the maximum load taken up by the weld or by the plate is determined by the area of the plate multiplied by the permissible stresses. Now the area of the plate is 100 into 12.5 multiplied by sigma T, that is equal to 70. So the maximum load taken up by this plate comes out to be 87.5 into 10 raised to 3 Newton. Now putting the value of W in equation 1, we will have this equation. Now from this equation we can find out the value of L, that comes out to be 70.72 millimeter. Now for starting and stopping of the weld, we add 12.5 millimeter. So the total length of the weld comes out to be L is equal to 70.72 plus 12.5, that comes out to be 83.22 millimeter. So this is the length of the weld for static loading. Now we will determine the length of weld for dynamic loading. Strength of weld for dynamic loading. Now the equation for dynamic loading is W is equal to 1.414 into S into L multiplied by sigma T upon Kf. The difference in static loading and dynamic loading, we consider the stress concentration factor here. This is the difference only. So here, as we determine the length for dynamic loading, so we'll consider the stress concentration factor Kf. So now the maximum load taken up by the plate is determined by area into permissible stresses, that comes out to be 87.5 into 10 raised to 3 Newton. Now putting the value of W in this equation, the equation becomes W is equal to 1.414 into 12.5 into L into 70 upon 1.5. Now from this equation we will determine the value of L, that comes out to be 106.07 millimeter. Now for starting and stopping, for starting and stopping of the weld, we add 12.5 millimeter. Now total length of weld for dynamic loading, that will be the summation of 106.07 plus 12.5, that comes out to be 118.57 millimeter. So loading. So this is about the welded joint or the how to determine the strength of the weld for double transfer fillet weld for static loading and dynamic loading. Thank you very much.